I want to take just a few minutes here to show you how I handle projects and tasks in Rome Research. For me, most of my real tasks are over in a different system. I help run a web agency, so we have our whole task management, project management system that's meant for that kind of thing. So I don't do a lot of that in here, but I do have a lot of one-off tasks that I'll put in Rome. So I'll show you a bit about each if you wanted to put more structured tasks in and how to handle one-offs. So for structured tasks, what I do is create a page called Projects. Just make a new page called Products, and then I star that so it stays in the sidebar so you can get to it quickly. And then I have some projects, each one just with brackets going around it, and then a few housekeeping tasks I can put wherever I have in here. So if we were to go into a new swing set, that might be a project you have. So you have four things here: print plans, buy wood, get a new saw, and then every year I want to seal the wood. And so print plans I had scheduled for today, and so I use the scheduled hashtag. I'll show you that in a minute. And I have today's date on it, and you'll see that's why today it showed up. It shows up in my linked references for the day. That's exactly what I want it to do. However, I have some problems here because these need some dates and they're not showing up yet. So I want to do a few things here. So buy wood, I'll probably do tomorrow, Saturday, and get a new saw tomorrow. And then seal the wood annually. I don't need to do that for a little while. So we'll do the date picker and maybe do it in a couple weeks and then annually from there. So maybe Saturday, May 9th sounds good. So now they all have dates. They'll all show up when they need to go. That's great. Couple problems though. I want to be able to keep up with this stuff better. And it's not going to be easy to see from there. They'll show up where they need to be, but it's easy to lose things without a few more hashtags on them. I'll show you that. But if we go back out, the way I normally do things is have them just come up day to day. Again, I don't do a lot of projects for mine, and I'll get more into projects in a minute, but I mostly just do things during the day. So if I was back a couple days ago, say I was here on April 20th, just in my daily notes, I might say, do the record. Let's say record. Record the Rome video about tasks. And so make it a to-do, and then I'll date it for, actually, it's about today. But on the 20th, you can type in a date, any date in the future, as long as you use the right syntax, with the 24th is in there, or you can use the date picker to pick it out. But I do a lot of things into the future. So what that does is that just in my daily notes, I'll do a lot of those. And as long as I put a date on it, it will bubble up today. Record the Rome video about tasks. There it is. The problem is if I forget to put a date on it, it very easily can get lost. So we'll take the date off for a minute and just say, I put this in here so I don't forget to do it, but you know, days later, you're gonna totally forget that task was there. So I have three things I do to try to help keep things organized. And I have these in the projects as recurring tasks that come up every week. I do these once a week, usually on Fridays, to keep things clean. So first I check for open tasks that aren't scheduled. So what I'll do there, I guess I'll back up for a sec. I have scheduled and recurring. These, if it has scheduled, that means I have a date on it. And if it's recurring, it means I don't ever want to check it off. I want to just change the date when it happens. So check for open tasks that aren't scheduled. So in your Rome, whether you've created it or whether you know it or not, you have a page called To Do. It's there and it'll show all your to do's. So in here, I have all the tasks that are open, but I want to make sure everyone has dates on it. And I don't know for sure that they all do. So what I can do, and of course there's the one in there, when I put a date on one, I put the hashtag schedule so I know I've dated it. So if I go into the filter and just say hide anything with scheduled, I'll just shift click on this. It hides all the scheduled ones. And then in my case, I have some just open things in metadata, so I'll collapse that. So here's really the ones I need to deal with. So now I can say, okay, buy the wood. Yep, I forgot to put the hashtag on there. So it is scheduled. Cool. And this one is scheduled. Cool. And they go away as you click off them. And then this one's scheduled. And then, oops, sure enough, I'm glad I did this review because I forgot to schedule that one. So that one I'm going to do today. And then I can now mark it as scheduled. So every week I just kind of go through, make sure everything has a date. So there shouldn't be any open to-dos in here that aren't scheduled. Now, they could be in the past, and we'll look at that in a second too. But everything in here at least is scheduled. So now I can remove the filter here and just see all the tasks if I wanted to. So that's good. So we'll go back to daily notes, check for closed tasks that were, check for open tasks that aren't scheduled. We took care of that. So all I'll do here, again, it's recurring, so I don't want to accidentally check it off. But let's suppose that it is. Yep, I took care of it. Check it off. The problem is now it's going to kind of disappear. So the next one I'm going to look at, we'll go up to this one here, is check for closed tasks that were recurring. Because again, if it has recurring, that's kind of my signal to myself that I shouldn't check it off. I should just change the date. But again, this may drift down a few days and I might miss it. So there's another page that you have in Rome automatically called Done. So we want to Done. This is all the tasks in here that are completed. So again, what I'll do in here is go to the filters and I want to show any that say recurring. So if it's recurring, it shouldn't ever be in here. Recurring tasks should never be done because I should just change them. So in this case, I'll say, oops, I didn't mean to do that. So let me change the date. So usually I just do the date picker. I want to do it again next Friday. So there's May 1st, and then just delete today's date from it. Okay, we're good. And then uncheck it so it's no longer done. And cool. Again, now we're clean here. So there's a little bit of housekeeping on that. So we'll go back out here. So that's cleaned up now, and actually it went away. So check for closed tasks or recurring is all set. So this task now, I fixed the other one. Now I want to fix this one. So we'll do the date picker and remind me again next week to check on that stuff. And so now that will go away. And then the last little bit of housekeeping I do is I like to check the past week for missed tasks. So this is where, again, a task might be scheduled, but I might have just kind of forgotten about it. I got too busy one day and didn't get to the task. So now it's not going to show up in those reviews because it is scheduled. It does have a date. It's just in the past. Now, there's more robust queries and things you can do that are still a little bit wonky, but coming along nicely. And I'm trying to stick with just core Rome features for now. So this is kind of the easiest way for me to do that. If I'm doing this a week at a time, there's not much hanging out in here that I might miss. So I'll scroll down a little bit and kind of look. Yep, no tasks in here. No task in here. Actually, I do have that one, but that's scheduled. I had written it there, so it's good. I didn't miss one that should have been there. Date finished. Yep, and I'm back far enough. So I went back a week. Everything's good, so I checked the missed tasks. Again, I'll date that for a week out. So really, my cleanup every week takes, I mean, you just saw it, should just take a couple minutes. And really, if you don't mess up, it should take even less time if you've not checked off your recurring tasks and that kind of thing. So it should be good to go. Now, we have a couple more things sitting out here in my references, but these are both scheduled for today and good to go. So I would go to the swing set and print the plans, or if I'm not going to get to it, just add a new date to this instead, change it tomorrow. But say we print it and then record the Rome video about tasks. Again, I can finish that one here in just a second. So going back into projects now, you'll see, again, these are sitting out here. You maybe would want to hide them just under, you know, weekly cleanup or something to kind of get it out of your way a little bit. We could do that and then just kind of indent these guys in and keep that collapsed because you don't need to see that when you're here. But in theory, this could be a whole list of different tasks, each one full of tasks. That stuff's all set. It's scheduled. It's in the future. You're not going to miss them this way. And just that little bit of cleanup each week will keep it good. And then for me, again, the beautiful thing is during my daily notes, I can just quickly just knock a task in here. I need to do something next week, and it'll automatically show up that week under the link references and does a great job. So Rome isn't great for high scale task management, sharing with other people, that kind of stuff. But for me, I'm in Rome so much every day, it made sense to take all these little personal reminders and put them in here because I'm going to see them here more than I would in Todoist or Notion or anywhere else I might put them. So I'm going to be in here anyhow. I'm going to see those. And then again, I have those three little things to help clean up just in case I miss something. And those three things seem to pretty well cover me, so nothing can escape. It does a good job. So if you have other tips on how to handle these even better, please leave a comment and we can all learn from that. Thanks.